triple decker act before. So I think it'll be interesting because I have a lot of respect for them. I will be reading largely in English. Anamika is a fantastic Hindi poet, so she'll take on the Hindi thread. And Saif, Urdu mein karenge. We were given a topic, so I have to tell you that up front. Largely, it can be summed by this four-letter word which everybody knows, which is love. I'll pick up erotic love as seen in contemporary English language poetry. Saif will pick it up and talk about mystic love as in Urdu poetry. And finally, Anamika will talk about woman love as in Hindi poetry. And right at the end, we, all of us, as a chorus, like the Greek chorus, will, but also in the Urdu tradition, just recite a couplet from our mother tongues. Bengali in my case, Urdu and Hindi. So growing up in India, one of the things I have to say is it is really alarming and baffling that we come from a tradition where we have Kama Sutra that was written in our country. We have the Khajuraho temple, the Konarak temples. We have this great tradition of Tamil Sangam poetry where fabulously beautiful erotic poetry was written, as was the case in the Bhakti movement or the Sufi movement. But what is really, really strange is modern India, 21st century India, people are supposed to be liberated, but people are very shy in terms of addressing this very, very important aspect of love. And to the point that they hide it under the wraps, to the point that the government shuts websites down and so on and so forth. So there's no place to not only dissent, but also humor is missing. So what I'll do is I'll read three poems of mine, which from erotic text, which will give you a flavor of three kinds of erotic love. And the first one is called Desire. Under the soft, translucent linen, the ridges around your nipples harden at the thought of my tongue. You, lying inverted like the letter C, arch yourself deliberately, wanting the warm press of my lips. It's wet to coat the skin that is bristling, burning, breaking into sweats of desire, sweet juices of imagination. But in fact, I haven't even touched you. At least, not yet. So what happens with erotic writing, it's quite a challenge because if you push it too hard, it enters the P space, the pornography space. If you undercook it, it's like callow love poetry, which we've all written as high school students or college students. So how do you skate this very sharp razor edge of a line where the balance is just has to be just pitch perfect? And it's a difficult act because the amount of editing that goes behind this, you know, to get that perfection in place. This one is simply called Kiss, and it uses a Japanese form, the haiku, the 17 syllable, three line poem. A languorous kiss, the faintest smell of ocean, salt lipped breeze, leading. And that's where this entire idea of suggestion is more important. Less is more. And often in poetry, that is a critical sort of space where often we forget that in silence, we have more power, more energy. And I'll end with something that will nicely segue with what Saif is going to do. It's moving from sort of erotic love to spiritual or mystic love. To me, the separation point is very, very fine. It's almost like either side of the coin. Glued. Glued together, we lie incurably conjoined. Just as the sky and the earth are joined by an indeterminate horizon, so are we made one by an indeterminate faith.
Chehre pe mere zulf ko phailao kisi din. Chehre pe mere zulf ko phailao kisi din. Kya roz garajte ho? Baras jao kisi din. Erotica. Sudeep talked about erotica. Just look at the metaphors that Amjad Islam Amjad uses in this poem to ask his beloved to make love. So bold, yet so subtle. Chehre pe mere zulf ko phailao kisi din. Kya roz garajte ho? Baras jao kisi din. Razon ki tarah utro mere dil mein kisi shab. Razon ki tarah utro mere dil mein kisi shab aur dastak pe mere haath ki khul jao kisi din. Pedon ki tarah husn ki barish mein nahalu. Pedon ki tarah husn ki barish mein nahalu. Badal ki tarah jhoom ke gir jao kisi din. Aur khushboo ki tarah guzro mere dil ki gali se. Phoolon ki tarah mujh pe bikhar jao kisi din. Ye Amjad Islam the. And then the next stage, the almost mystic state in which both of them find themselves after their desire has been fulfilled. Fehmida Riaz, pehli baar. Pehli baar, pyaar ke baad, ek dooje ki baahon mein, itne nihatte, itne nazuk, saans jhijhak kar lete hain. Kaanch ke putle toot na jaye. Fehmida Riaz. And then, my friends, is Mustafa Zaidi, who audaciously announces that his beloved, in his spiritual journey, shares only his body and his bed. An unparalleled example of being sensitive and delicate, and yet so audacious. Fankar khud na thi, mere fan ki sharik thi. Not an artist herself, she shared my art. Sharik is Urdu for sharing. Fankar khud na thi, mere fan ki sharik thi, wo rooh ke safar mein badan ki sharik thi. Aur utra tha jis pe baabe haya ka varak varak. On who? Each page of the divine chapter of divinity, of modesty, was revealed like in a divine book. Utra tha jis pe baabe haya ka varak varak. Bistar ki ek ek shikan ki sharik thi. Aur main ek aitbar se aatash parast tha. I was a fire worshipper from one angle. Main ek aitbar se aatash parast tha. Wo sare zaviyon se chaman ki sharik thi. Wo sare zaviyon se chaman ki sharik thi. And who but Faiz can describe the condition of a person before he falls in love and compare it with one after he falls in love. And mind you, this love is not romantic alone. It is erotic, it is mystic, it is that selfless love, it is spiritual, all at once. Tum jo na aaye the, to har cheez wahi thi, ki jo hai. Tum jo na aaye the, to har cheez wahi thi, ki jo hai. Aasma, hadde nazar, rah guzar, rah guzar, shishaye mein, shishaye mein. Aur ab, shishaye mein, rah guzar, रंगे फलक रंग है मेरा खून जिगर होने तक चंपई रंग कभी राहत दीदार का रंग सुरमई रंग कभी साते बेजार का रंग जर्द पत्तों का खसोखार का रंग सुर्ख फूलों का दहकते हुए गुलजार का रंग जहर का रंग लहू रंग शबेतार का रंग अब जो आए हो तो ठहरो नाउ दैट यू आर हियर स्टे अब जो आए हो तो ठहरो कि कोई रंग कोई रुत कोई शय एक जगह पर ठहरे फिर से एक बार हर एक चीज वही हो कि जो है आसमां हद नजर राह गुजर शीशा ए में एंड द ग्रैंड फिनाले लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन अगेन फेज And I had actually chosen Mir for this, but something while I was coming here made me change my mind to something else. And that something else is the epitome of selfless love. It is Faiz addressing his Raqib, the lover of his beloved. Raqib say. Faiz binds himself into a spiritual relationship with his Raqib and says, and puts him in an exalted position, saying, only you alone can understand my love. Raqib say. Ah, ke wabasta hain us husn ki yaadein tujh par. Ah, ke wabasta hain us husn ki yaadein tujh se, jisne is dil ko parikhana bana rakha tha. Jiski ulfat mein saja rakhi thi dunya humne. Deher ko deher ka afsana bana rakha tha. Aashna hai tere kadmon se wo raahein jin par uski madhosh jawani ne inayat ki hai. Karwaan guzre hain jisse us hiranai ke jiski in aankhon ne besood ibadat ki hai. Tune dekhi hai wo peshani wo rukhsar wo hont zindagi jiske tasavvur mein luta di humne. Tujh pe utthi hain wo khoi hui sahir aankhein tujhko maloom hai kyun umr gawa di humne. Hum pe mushtarka hai ehsaan ghame ulfat ke. We share the sorrows of love. Hum pe mushtarka hai ehsaan ghame ulfat ke. Itne ehsaan ki ginwaun to ginwa na sakun. Humne is pyar mein kya khoya hai, kya sikha hai, juz tere kisi ko samjhaun to samjha na sakun. Bahut shukriya.
Ask a photographer and he'll tell you that from a given angle, every human face looks divinely beautiful. Ask a woman, and she'll tell you that there is something lovable in the weakest or the crudest of us, in relationships, where even strange partners survive as great friends. More often than not, it's the more evolved of the two who chooses to play the woman and adopt the more difficult one as yet another child. But bearing the brunt of a challenged relationship is not that easy. And that's why they take recourse to humor. Humor, you all know, is a great leveler. And how do they create humor? By a funny coupling of the heterogenic opposites. Personal coupling of the personal with the political, sacred with the profane, and cosmic with the commonplace. Hindi love poetry, especially my poetry, offers you a mocktail of rasas, Shringar, Hasya, and Karuna. And the poem I'm going to present is called Ek Aurat Ka Pehla Rajkiye Pravas. Woh hotel ke kamre mein dakhil hui. अपने अकेलेपन से उसने बड़ी गर्मजोशी के साथ हाथ मिलाया. कमरे में अंधेरा था, खूब अंधेरा था कुएं का, उसके भीतर भी सारी दीवारें टटोरी अंधेरे में, लेकिन स्विच कहीं नहीं था. आधा खुला था दरवाजा, बरामदे की रोशनी से ही काम चल रहा था. सामने से गुजरा जो बेरा तो आर्त भाव से उसे देखा, उसने उलझन समझी और बाहर खड़े ही खड़े दरवाजा बंद कर दिया. दरवाजा बंद होते ही रोशनी के खुल गए सहस्र दल कमल. भला बंद होने से रोशनी का क्या है रिश्ता, उसने सोचा. डनलप पर लेटी, चटाई चुभी कहीं रीढ़ के भीतर, तो क्या एक राजकुमारी ही होती है हर औरत, और सात गलीचों के भीतर भी उसको चुभ जाता है कोई मटर दाना आदिम स्मृतियों का. पढ़ने को बहुत कुछ धरा था, पर उसने बाँची टेलीफोन तालिका और जानना चाहा अंतर्राष्ट्रीय दूरभाष का ठीक ठाक खर्चा। फिर अपने सब डॉलरें खर्च कर उसने तीन किए अलग अलग कॉल। सबसे पहले अपने बेटे से कहा, हेलो हेलो बेटे, पैकिंग के वक्त सूटकेस में ही तुम ऊँग गए थे कैसे? सबसे ज़्यादा याद आ रही है तुम्हारी, तुम हो मेरे सबसे प्यारे। अंतिम दोनों पंक्तियाँ अलग अलग उसने कहीं। दफ्तर में बैठकर अंट शंट सोचते अपने प्रिय से, फिर चौके में चिंतित बर्तन खटकाती अपनी माँ से। अब उसकी हुई गिरफ्तारी, पेशी हुई खुदा के सामने कि इसी एक जुबा से उसने तीन तीन लोगों से कैसे ये कहा, तुम हो मेरे सबसे प्यारे। ये तो सरासर है धोखा, सबसे ज्यादा माने सबसे ज्यादा। लेकिन खुदा ने कलम रख दी और कहा, औरत है उसने ये गलत नहीं कहा।
So I'll just recite just two lines from my favorite poem in the entire world. This is a modernist poet, Jivananda Dash, and the epic poem, many of you in the audience probably know it, Bonulata Sen. I wish I was related to her, then I could marry her. Unfortunately, she's only a mythic character. The Bengali, of course, is very, very beautiful. I'll just read the first two lines of the second stanza. Chultar kobekar ondhokar bidhishar nisha muktar shrabostir karokarjo. Like the dense ink night of bidhisha, her hair black, deep black, her face like the filigree frieze of shrabostir's filigree frieze.
And I will end with these two lines, a couplet from Parveen Shakir, who speaks in the tradition of Amir Khusro. Is shart pe khelungi piya pyar ki bazi. Is shart pe khelungi piya pyar ki bazi. Jeetun to tujhe paun, haarun to piya teri.
And this is my intertextual dialogue with a woman bhakt, the poet Janabai. I picked up one line and built up a dialogue, and it says, Hey Madhav, kitne to kaam dhare hain sar par, kitne kapde goodne hain, kitna aata goodna hai, kuch to karo, thoda to haath bata do are, kuch to karo, meri juye her do, magar kuch to karo, Hey Madhav, yun hi nithalle na baitho.